Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
Some wonder, consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. That God, His Son not sparing, sent Him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on a cross, my burdens gladly bearing, He bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee, how great Thou art, how great Thou art. How great Thou art, how great Thou art.
Dear God, our Heavenly Father, we your children gather here this evening to praise, honor, and glorify your name. Your name is the name above all names, and it is at your name that every knee shall bow. Lord, you are awesome, and your love is immeasurable. You have reached down in love, and through your Son Jesus, you have made us sons and daughters. And for this, dear Father, we are grateful. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for all the blessings you have bestowed on us. The sun, the rain, the vegetation of the earth, our food, our families, friends, and roofs over our head. Father in heaven, we count our blessings with hearts of gratitude. And dear God, we come to you knowing that we are not always the persons you expect us to be. Sometimes we fail to show your love to others. We have not forgiven those who may have wronged us. We have failed to extend a helping hand to those in need. And for those other things, and for all the other misdemeanors that we have created, we humbly ask your forgiveness. Mold and shape us according to your will, and create within us clean hearts. Gracious Father, I bring the peoples of the world before you, many of them who are going through many challenges. I think specifically of the people of Haiti and Afghanistan. Lord, only you can walk with them through their storms and lead them out victorious. Lord, they need to feel you near. They need to know that you're walking with them, even though they may be going through the valley of the shadow of death. May they know that of your promise to be with us at all times, and that this promise is real. Help them to claim this promise. You said you will never leave us or forsake us. Help them to know that your promises are true. And Lord, I bring the speaker for this evening before you. Give him or her the message that you intend for us to hear at this time. May our hearts be open to accept the words as he or she shares from you. May we all be blessed as we seek to follow you and to do your will. And may others see you in us. This I pray, and pray all these things through the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
See you. The scripture reading for tonight's devotion is taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verses 28 to 34. Reading from verse 28. One of the scribes came near and heard them disputing with one another. And seeing that he answered them well, he asked him, "Which commandment is the first of all?" Jesus answered, "The first is, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. The second is this, You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." Then the scribe said to him, "You are right, teacher. You have truly said that he is one, and beside him there is no other. And to love him with all the heart, and all the understanding, and with all the strength, and to love one's neighbors as oneself, this is much more important than all whole burnt offerings and sacrifices." When Jesus saw that he answered wisely, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." The Gospel of Christ. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we gather virtually at this time to worship you and sing your praises. We bless you for your creation and all the blessings of this life. Father God, we adore your name and glorify you forever. It is by your will that we are alive and healthy. Come into our midst in this hour and fellowship with us, that we may embrace and hold fast to the hope of everlasting life. Pour on us the abundance of your blessings, now and forevermore, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The reflection on the theme for tonight's devotion is based on the Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verse 34. You are not far from the kingdom of God. On reflecting on this statement, is Jesus complimenting the scribe, or is Jesus issuing a stern warning? Does this statement encourage others to aim for a deeper relationship within God's kingdom? But what are kingdoms? Throughout the scriptures, there are references to many kingdoms. Since God is the creation of everything, God rules over his creation, his kingdom, his spiritual kingdom, and his physical kingdom. The psalmist in Psalm 24 verse 1 declares, "The earth is the Lord's and everything in it, the world and all who live in it." In the book of Daniel chapter 2, King Nebuchadnezzar dreamt of four kingdoms that would dominate the world: Babylon, Persia, Greece, and Rome. Daniel interprets that the dream foretells that these four great Gentile kingdoms would rise as supreme world governments. But finally, God's kingdom would triumph over all earthly kingdoms. My friend, God is sovereign over all. Then there is the kingdom of Israel and Judah that were both conquered by the Assyrians and the Babylonians. Why? Because God warned the Israelites in Deuteronomy chapter 17, verse 14 to 20, about demanding a king. God said, "Be sure to appoint over you the king the Lord your God chooses." God's king was to be a naturalized Israelite, forbidden from marrying foreign wives or accumulating vast amount of wealth of gold and silver. Moreover, this king must always have in his possession a copy of God's words at all times. This was God's king, a king separated from the pagan world to lead God's people into righteous living. But the Israelite elders in 1 Samuel chapter 8 verse 4 to 20 insisted on the appointment of an earthly king, a physical king that can be seen like those of the surrounding nations. A dejected Samuel warned the Hebrews that they were rejecting God, a God who freed them from slavery and parted the sea, enabling the Hebrews to escape the Egyptian army, a God who fed them manna for 40 years in the wilderness and led them to victories over their enemies. Then God advises Samuel in 1 Samuel chapter 8 verse 7. "Listen to the voice of the people in all that they say to you, for they have not rejected you, but they have rejected me from being the king over them." By defying God's word, the disobedient inhabitants of the northern kingdom were exiled to Assyria, and those of the southern kingdom to Babylon. But what is the kingdom of God? The term kingdom of God or kingdom of heaven refers to the spiritual realm over which God reigns as king. Psalms 22 verse 28 confirms that the kingdom is the Lord's and he rules over the nations. Christians' fundamental belief is that God is king. The kingdom of God refers to the rule of Jesus on this earth and to all those blessings that flows from God. It is the reign of Christ in the church. It is the reign of Christ in our hearts. It is the reign of Christ in our lives. It is a time when Christ sets up his kingdom. It is when Christ begins his dominion on this earth. In John chapter 18, verse 36, when Pontius Pilate asked Jesus if he is the King of the Jews, Jesus responded, "My kingdom is not of this world." Earlier, Jesus taught his disciples the Lord's Prayer in Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 to 15, the prayer that the Father's kingdom will come to earth as it is in heaven. Reflecting on this chapter of Mark 12, Jesus is in the temple, teaching and speaking in parables about the wicked tenants, the widow's offering, and arguing with the Pharisees and Herodians about paying taxes to Caesar, debating with the Sadducees about the resurrection, and denouncing the scribes for their public display, their insistence on prominence, their taking advantage of the less fortunate, and their long prayers. My friends, the scribes were the experts on the law and were the legal advisors. But despite Jesus' criticism, the scribe asked the question, which commandment is the most important of all? Maybe this question was highly debated among the theological scholars at that time. Jesus responded in verse 29 to 31 by reference to Deuteronomy 6 and Leviticus 19. Scriptures the Jews read daily about loving God and loving neighbor. God wants love for both himself and love for others. But this scribe was only interested in the theology and not the spiritual aspect of Jesus' response. The scribe wanted to know Jesus' thoughts rather than live what Jesus taught. God does not want us to have biblical knowledge only, but to know him and to know him abundantly. To know that we are saved by Christ, by faith in Christ alone. Unlike the scribe, God wants us to use our knowledge of him, not for our pride, but for his glory. Just having knowledge of God's words, like all those who were interacting with Jesus, is not enough to bring us into the kingdom of God. Knowing the scriptures is not verification for salvation. Jesus said in John chapter 5, verse 39, "You search the scriptures because you think them. In them you have eternal life, and it is there that bear witness about me." Some persons, Christians too, use their theological knowledge only for conversation and debating, and not for the glorification of God. What does it mean to love God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength? It means we must give all of ourselves over to God. God does not want just a part of us. God requires the whole, the heart, the soul, the mind, and the strength. "Come to me, all who labor and are heavily laden, and I will give you rest. The kingdom of God is for repentant souls." My friends, those who acknowledge that there are sinners seeking the Savior, Jesus Christ, truly believe in all that God reveals through his word, recognizing Christ's shed blood as his atonement for our sins, certainly a crucial part of the process to the kingdom of God. Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, you have made known to us the things of the kingdom. May we be able to love you and our neighbor as ourselves. May we bring honor and glory to your name in all that we say and do. Heavenly Father, use us to lead those who are wandering and confused into the veil of the truth. Give us that wisdom that leads to abundant love and faith to acknowledge you as Savior. In Jesus' name, we believe and pray. Amen and amen.
There is a name I love to hear. I love to sing its worth. It sounds like music in my ear, the sweetest name on earth. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. It tells me of a Savior's love who died to set me free. It tells me of his precious blood, the sinner's perfect plea. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. Tells of one whose loving heart can fill my deepest woe, who in each sorrow bears a part that none can bear below. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me. How I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Oh, how I love Jesus. Because he first loved me.
Jesus.
Thank you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word, and may it dwell in all of us richly.